Over the past 6 years, six very special girls have become Britain's next top model. Lucy. Leanna. Lauren. Alex. Misha. Tiffany. 2011, and it's back. In command of the search for Britain and Ireland's next top model is Elle McPherson, an iconic superstar whose career has spanned three decades. The judges helping Elle in the quest for Britain and Ireland's next top model are international fashion designer Julian McDonald. Julian is the designer credited with bringing high fashion to the high street and has worked with an array of supermodels. Award-winning top editorial stylist Grace Woodward. Grace styles for Elle, Nylon, Harper's Bazaar and most recently The X Factor. International model Charley Speed. He has graced the catwalk for huge designers such as Gucci, Versace and Prada, and has worked alongside supermodels such as Kate Moss. This year, and for the first time, the judges are on the road as they audition across the country. In Glasgow, London, Cardiff, Birmingham, Manchester, and Ireland's capital, Dublin. Thousands have applied, and this year the prizes are bigger than ever. The winner will receive a contract with leading agency Models One, a six-page spread and the cover of Company magazine, a luxury holiday for two to the Sandals Royal Plantation Resort in Jamaica with business class flights courtesy of British Airways, a brand new Peugeot RCZ sports coupe to help get around those important castings, a cosmetics campaign with Revlon, and a £50,000 international campaign with Miss Selfridge, which will feature in over 250 stores across the globe. Over the next 3 weeks, hundreds of girls will face the panel, and with their dreams in the judges' hands, tears, tension, joy, and drama are never far away.
They can't take it anymore. You know, I've been to so many agencies and they're like, oh, we can't take her. I think, what is wrong with me?
That girl could really get into the last three. No way.
Yeah.
Can you come back?
Julian, what were you thinking? 1 minute you're sitting here, the next minute you're out, pull her in.
She's really special. Mm.
Yeah, but we can talk about it as a team.
Yes. You're doing it.
Woo! I thank you so much. It actually made me this strong, confident, competitive person I am today.
All who say
I say yes.
Okay, except you.
Yes, it is.
Give us your best catwalk.
Hey,
it's Missy McFizzy on the run.
TV, I'm sorry.
There she is. That's our Wonder Woman.
Oh,
there
she is.
You don't look like a girl in Vogue magazine.
But why? They're saying that I haven't got the right look for modelling. If I look at Elle McPherson, neither is she.
You can tell Grace I think she's a
See ya.
Coming up. The audition tour lands in Glasgow and one of the fashion capitals of the world, London. The judges are reunited.
Much good.
Hi. What is that?
By the end of the show, I'm going to be full left.
And Charley Speed is put to the ultimate test as he scouts for girls with model potential on the streets of Glasgow.
Would you be interested in maybe coming to an audition?
Yeah.
With hundreds of girls all fighting to be noticed, they try every trick in the book to catch the eye of the panel.
You'll never find no one like me. I'm Great TV, I'm sorry.
But when it comes down to the serious business of finding Britain and Ireland's next top model, tears are never far away.
I want the world at my feet. I want to do what you do. I want to be what you are.
For the girls who have been patiently waiting, the morning of the Glasgow auditions has finally arrived. Audition doors open, one judge arrives in Glasgow, touching down in style.
I haven't seen my other judges. Grace just texts me and said, what are you wearing? She said, I'm wearing red. I said, cool, I'm wearing black. So I'm excited to see Julian and Grace and Charlie, of course, but I'm so excited to see the girls. I'm excited to see all the weird, wonderful, beautiful creatures that have come out to display their wares here in Glasgow. And, you know, it's going to be exciting.
With Elle winging her way to the venue, Charlie, Grace and Julian are looking forward to finding out what Glasgow has to offer.
I mean, what's so exciting about today is that, you know, it's the first time we've ever had open auditions, so we've got no idea what kind of girls are going to turn up.
I don't even know what Scottish girls look like. Are they fat, thin, tall? Do they eat haggis? Do they drink whiskey? It's a surprise, but, you know, this is what it is. It's a live audition, and let's hope we find a fantastic girl.
And the girls just keep arriving, all with one dream, to become Britain and Ireland's next top model.
Competition today actually looks quite tough. There's a lot of good girls, good-looking girls, tall girls, original girls, different-looking girls. I think it's going to be really hard.
It's really exciting to be here today. I totally don't know what to expect.
She is here!
Brown munchkin!
We had...
Julian, your hair!
Turn it into you.
What is with that?
By the end of the show, I'm going to be full length.
Oh my God!
I'm turning into you bit by bit, week by week.
This year, I would like to be a little bit more rigorous about height. I think that's the number one thing. And I want to see girls with style. Yeah,
somebody that stood out from the crowd who actually looked like a model, but perhaps was a bit special. Perhaps the style
group. Okay, well, we've got a lot of girls to see, so I think we should go and see them. And I have to get my face on. That's why I have my glasses on, because I have no face. How close are you guys? How much time do you need?
Are we ready to roll?
Ready.
Ready? Okay, give me 10 minutes.
Cool. We just spent the last 4 hours waiting for you to arrive.
Excuse me?
On the private jet.
Woohoo! I was working in Geneva. With many people. Stars.
After a quick makeup pit stop for Elle, the judges enter the audition room for the first time.
Do we look like really powerful? Here, this is me. Get rid of this. Oh! There it goes. How's that?
The judges are ready, and the first group of girls can't wait to meet them and show them what they've got.
I think I'm different, and I think that the judges will see my sense of style, my character, my confidence, I think, my confidence and passion. I think those are the things that really shine through with me.
All the girls that I'm competing against are gorgeous, but then I think I've maybe got a wee bit of an edge.
Okay, come on, bring in the girls.
Hi.
Hello, ladies.
Could you give us your best catwalk? This is your time to shine.
My yoga teacher says if you look down, that's the way you're going to go. Let's move on.
You have a fantastic bone structure. You have a really interesting face.
How tall are you?
5'9".
5'9". You're not 5'9".
Apparently I am.
Give us your best catwalk walk. Okay, the next one.
I'm currently working as a care assistant, which I love. I love working with people, and I'm a very good Highland dancer.
Apart from the bikini, can you tell me something interesting about yourself?
I actually made it to the final top three of Fife's Next Top Model, and I have been raising lots of publicity for charities.
Can you take your hat off?
Yes.
Can we see
you?
Perhaps you should put it back on.
and girls, we're going to take some time to talk.
I thought two of them were really good.
I was so loving when she was dancing, and she was so brave.
She was good.
Hopefully I've done enough to get through it. I gave it 100%, so I can't do any better than that.
I thought the second one and the end one were really
interesting. Yeah, they were the most interesting.
You're just so nervous, your body doesn't seem to do what you're telling it to, but I hope that they can see some potential in you despite that.
So, Holly, could you step forward, please? Congratulations, Holly. You've made it through.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Really pleased. I don't know, it all seems so surreal, but I can assure you I'm so happy right now.
So with the first group out of the way and the first girl through to the boot camp semi-finals, Glasgow is off to a great start. Next up and hoping to stand out from the crowd is 20-year-old Tanya.
It would mean the world to me to be the next top model. It used to be such a good thing, a positive thing. Something that I've done in my life that I can be proud of.
What makes you better than the three girls by the side of you?
I'm just really driven for this. I want to be able to do something with my life.
What is it that makes you special enough to go the whole way?
I suppose it's not all about just being pretty, is it? It's about wanting to do something.
Okay, girls, we're going to have a little chat and we'll be calling you back in shortly and see if any of you get through to the semi-finals.
I'm not very good in situations like that, so just nervous. I feel a bit sick.
There was two on the end. I've definitely got potential based on what we've seen today.
With this chance that could change Tanya's life forever and her fate in the judges' hands, emotions take hold.
Tessa. Can you please step forward? Congratulations, you've made it through to the semi-finals. And the other girls, you can leave. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Tanya, will you wait here, please? You look very upset. We are undecided. We see something in you, okay?
It means so much to me.
I want you to show me something or tell me something that's going to encourage us to put you through to the semi-finals. Whatever you reach inside and find within yourself now is what you will need to carry you through the rest of the competition if you stay.
I just want to be able to prove myself to some people that have put me down so much in the past. And I just wanted to prove to them that no matter what they've done, I could have came out on top and done something better with my life than what they've done. I want the world at my feet. I want to do what you do. I want to be what you are.
It takes a lot of hard work and a lot of luck along the way. And I think that as a panel, we'd like to give you this opportunity to move into the next round.
Thank you.
You can do this.
So get out there. Well done. Congratulations. Off you go.
See you.
Coming up, in the harsh world of fashion, sometimes honesty is the best policy.
Well, you know, I'll keep on living the dream.
Don't be so mean.
I'm not being mean.
That was really mean.
Starting to think I don't have the confidence now.
Oh, excuse me.
Charley Speed is scouting for girls on the streets of Glasgow.
5'7".
Yes.
She's got a look, but she's certainly not got a look for next top model. She's just not right.
And Julian is outvoted.
I say yes.
Okay, it's up to you.
Yes, it is.
Sorry,
okay, bring him in.
The search for Britain and Ireland's next top model has begun in Glasgow, and the auditions are in full swing. And the girls are doing everything they can on that catwalk to impress the judges. Registering for the competition are two familiar faces, Samira and Jennifer made it to Fashion Academy last year, but were heartbroken when they failed to make it into the top model house.
I'm feeling very shocked, but I will leave here with more confidence and I'm not going to give up.
I gave everything I could, and I don't know what else I could have done.
Last year I did really, really well, but I wasn't confident enough, whereas at least I feel this year I've gone away, I've built up a really good portfolio, I've worked hard and kind of proved to myself that I can do it, and now I'm back to show you guys that I can do it.
I think when I meet the judges, I'm going to be more confident and I'm going to show that I want it like really bad. Obviously last time I just stood there and smiled because I was really nervous.
A few familiar Samira. Faces.
Yeah. And Jennifer.
Samira.
Hello.
You're back.
Yeah.
It's so good to see you. You still look angry.
Angry. I was nervous. But...
if we didn't put you through last season, why would we put you through again?
I know I've got what it takes to be a top model.
Well, you know, I'll keep on living the dream.
Don't be so mean.
I'm not being mean.
That was really mean.
We've got another lady that's been here before as well.
After last year, I wanted to prove to myself that actually I can be good at this.
What, so after, like, four industry experts have said, oh, well, actually, we don't think you're going to make it?
Well, no, I think at the time, for you to let me get that far, there must have been something you'd seen.
I think you're probably one of the best we've seen today because I really love that swimsuit. I love your look. And do you know what? You seem like a really nice girl who's come back with a load of confidence.
OK, girls, now, what we're going to do is, if you guys don't mind to leave the room for a little bit, we're going to have a chat.
I think it went well, but I think Julie McDonald was a bit of... a bit harsh.
And I know Samira, we might owe it to her. So, look, we don't owe anything to anybody. She's not going to cut it.
Starting to think I don't have the confidence now.
What do you think about Jennifer?
I like Jennifer. I think she's came back. She's
really
confident.
Liked her.
And I really liked her. And I liked her. Look, I think she's, you know, let's give the girl a chance.
I definitely...
Yeah.
No, look, OK, excuse me, I'm going to pull rank here. I am going to call two names. They are Chelsea. Can you step forward, please? Jennifer, you girls have made it through to the semi-finals.
As always, they're looking for that girl with that extra special something. And 20-year-old Jade thinks she's got what they need.
I think I will stand out from the crowd because of my personality. I'm fun, I'm confident, and I think that's something you need to be the next top model.
OK, bring in the girls.
Doyle from Father Ted. Would you like a cup of tea, Father? Now go on, go on, go on, Father. Take a cup of tea. Do Lorraine Kelly. Oh, you are gorgeous. Welcome to GMTV. Heather Small, you've got those hot Father.
Britain's Got Talent auditions are next door.
Matt McCalling,
can you do me a favour? Can you remove your GO26 from your bust?
Wow,
that's what I was wondering. What are you hiding? Are they yours?
Yeah.
You're actually a bit of like a Turkish delight. Got the body, the bust, the face. Very sexy.
We'll call you back in the next couple of minutes.
I think I've done enough to get through to boot camp, hopefully. They seem to like my boobs, so always flaunt what you got.
Compared to some of the girls we've put through, she'd definitely be up there.
She's Turkish, she's different.
I like Turkish.
Let's give her a chance.
Should we give her a chance?
And I like Turkish Delight as well, my favourite.
Turkish Delight.
Hi, girls. You girls have all been fantastic today. You know, loads of personality, really entertaining. Giselle, could you step forward? You have made it through.
My friends were like, you're so beginning now, but no. It's just, I'm just so happy.
And as the day draws to an end, the last group of girls were found yesterday on the streets of Glasgow when top model judge Charley Speed went street casting.
We're here in sunny Glasgow, and hopefully we're going to have rich pickings, because we might find a potential winner. How tall are you?
5'9".
And how old are you?
29.
Oh, how fabulous does she look? The criteria for a model is pretty strict. Looks-wise, you can get quite creative, but there's a certain height and, you know, shape that is pretty much just a given. You need to find that. Oh, excuse me. Would you be interested in maybe coming to an audition?
Yeah.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
First one. That didn't take long, did it? Excuse me.
Yeah.
How tall are you? Honestly, how tall are you?
Five.
Six.
Six.
A bit short. That's such a shame. You're 5'7"?
Yeah.
She's got a look, but she's certainly not got a look for the next top model. It's just not right.
I recognise you.
Can you stand up? would you be willing to come to some auditions tomorrow?
Yes.
Sorry. You've got a great look. I think you've got a really great look. Great height. Great figure for it. If you're willing to come, that'd be great.
Thank you.
What are you doing tomorrow?
Meant to be at college?
It would be amazing if you could make it.
Okay, I'll try and think of it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Cool.
So with Charley finding four girls, it's time to find out what the other judges think of their potential.
We've all been really excited to meet you.
You chose well, Charley.
Well, it's a tough out there. I think I've done pretty well.
I think you've done really well. I like your choice of girl.
The thing is that everyone else came here willingly. And the thing is, I just found
you.
Pulled you
out. Forced you, yeah. Kicking and screaming.
Just give us a walk. Quite timid, but you can learn.
That was a little bit half-hearted, though.
Yeah. Charley, get up and show her how to do it.
If you just think about confidence, strength, and just forget that everyone's staring at you. Just stop. Oh, dear. Sorry.
Has that helped you at all?
Probably not.
Let's see the next girl.
OK, do you want to just leave the room briefly? We're going to have a little chat.
Not bad, Charles.
Charley, you did well.
Not bad.
You did really well.
I mean, I think there's two worth talking about.
Oh, there's not.
This, the really, really tall one. Yeah. She reminds me of girls that do London Catwalk.
No way.
Yeah, when the girls that come to do castings, she looks like them.
She does not.
She does. All who say
I say yes.
Okay, it's up to you.
Yes, it is.
Sorry, Al.
Okay, bring them in.
First of all, I just want to say thank you so much for coming in. Catherine, if you'd like to, we'd like you to put you through to the next round.
Please say yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's cool.
Good day.
Wow.
Long day, good day.
Let's go home.
Yeah.
I want to go see my kids.
Aww. Yeah. Let's all go home and see Al's kids.
Yeah. Let's go home and see my kids. Gonna pull up my pants.
This is Glasgow. Here we
Bye.
Go.
Glasgow.
They're going home.
It's really good fun. It's a lot more interactive, isn't it? A lot more interactive being out on the road. We get more of a say.
I like the fact that we're involved right from the beginning. It really does, because it's not just suddenly these girls turn up and you're like, oh, I'm going to pick you. What are you doing here? So we have to take responsibility for our choices now.
Ultimately.
Bye!
Bye, Glasgow!
auditions move to London.
London calling.
Where Julian takes dance class. And have the judges found their winner.
You'll never find no one like me. My personality is amazing. I'm great TV, I'm sorry.
Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model has moved to London. And we've arrived at Stamford Bridge, home to Chelsea Football Club, where the girls are eagerly awaiting to invade the fashion pitch.
You're better off trying to be unique and different and yourself rather than trying to model yourself for someone else. You're probably not going to be that successful.
Well, I don't really base myself on anyone, so I like to be a bit individual, really.
All that's needed now for the match to commence are the fashion referees.
Hi.
Good morning. It's Monday morning and we're in London.
I think London will be cool because I think we'll get lots of great street style. Because I think girls here have fantastic sort of dress sense. So it'll be good to see, you know, what the young ones have got.
London calling.
It's my hometown. This better be good. This better be good. I'm not interested in the models. We're at Chelsea Football Club.
Chelsea.
Where are the boys? Let me out the blues, eh?
Wherever.
Eh? Where are they? Where are they?
Wherever.
Just won the football.
Where?
We're in Chelsea. We're
So as the judges prepare themselves, some of the girls fall at the first hurdle, failing to reach the minimum height requirement of 5'8".
5'7". Sorry.
I've just turned 18 and I was like, oh yeah, yeah, I'm going to go get there early and never mind, I went the next year, hoped I would have grown.
But those who are tall enough furiously practice their moves. It's time to kick off the search for Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model in London.
Nothing scares me. This competition don't scare me. I'm just going to work my hardest, try my best. I think that will be enough. Be myself.
I think I'm quite unique and I really enjoy like modelling, so I think I've got a good chance.
I feel that I have the potential to be a model and I think that this competition will be really, really beneficial to me and I think I'll be an asset to it because I'm here and I'm willing to learn.
Ooh, you can see the hair coming up the stairs.
Yeah. Your hair proceeds.
Well, both of you actually.
Do you think you're tough enough for this industry?
I respond well to critique and I take direction well.
How would you describe yourself? What three words?
Creative and spontaneous.
I know I seem really shy now, but I am quite fun.
Well, Miss Fun Pants, let's see you do your best catwalk.
I think she has a nice face, just hides behind that hair.
Moving on to the next lady.
The prospect of being a model is all that's got me through the past couple of weeks, I have to say. I want to be a model so badly.
Got a waggle.
Yeah.
What's your bra size 34C?
Yeah, 34D.
Elle's the queen of the breast. Knows everything about bras.
Because that's my business.
I actually wrote something specific for the show, so I have got something prepared. Britain's Next Top Model. I'm here today because I want to be more than that girl with just the potential. I'm here for a reason. Oh, God, sorry.
It's good, it's good. You're doing really well. Just breathe.
I just want to be successful. And Britain's Next Top Model, I'm here and I'm ready.
Yay! I'd worry about you a little bit because, you know, you're obviously sensitive.
Very sexy, very confident.
You want to see me without the afro?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a wig, is it?
Oh, you cheeky monkey. Oh, you are cheeky.
We're going to have a quick chat. So if you wouldn't mind stepping out of the room and then we'll call you back when we're ready.
I like them all.
No, I don't like anything.
I hope I've done enough to get through because this means a lot to me and I'm really, really passionate about being here and being successful as a model.
If I had to, I have the second from last and the first, but they're not winning.
I like the one that's quite athletic.
I like the first one. She's great.
It's just a funny little English face. She did nothing in photography.
There was a lot of things I wanted to say, but I don't really. The time was short. I just hopefully they see something in me.
I'm going to ask them to do one more walk, and then we're going to make a decision.
What about all at the same time?
Yes. Decided that today we're going to put through Cat and Little Miss Afro.
I think that I would really also like to put through Anna.
Thank you.
Congratulations, girls. Well done.
I'm just heartbroken. I'm absolutely just gutted.
With so many girls in London for the judges to choose from, the pressure is on to stand out from the crowd.
Step for change. I can do it better than that.
Go on then, Jules. Go on, Jules. Step for change. Step for change.
And when it comes to standing out in the crowd, 18-year-old Melanie believes she's got everything the panel could ever need.
I know every girl's going to come here and say they have everything, but I actually do have everything. I have the walk, the personality, I could do commercial, high fashion, I can do beauty. I'm the biggest competition in this room. Personality-wise, I'm just in a different league to everyone in this room.
Hello.
I am a singer and dancer. You'll never find no one like me. My personality is amazing. I'm great TV, I'm sorry.
Why are you so brilliant then?
Because I'm everything that a person should be. I am creative, I'm a dancer, I know how my body looks. I'm very passionate. When I start something, I perfect it, I will finish it, and I will win this competition.
Do you think you might be a bit too much?
We have sayings in school, and one of ours is, oh, you're too much. Because we are too much, but it's too much in a good way. I'm not a horrible person.
You better have a really good walk. She's been practicing.
She reminds you a little bit of Lois Lane from the original Superman films.
Yeah, it's true.
Mm. Okay.
Oh, well.
Okay. Thank you very much. What about Mrs. Noisy for the house?
Oh, I liked her, but she's not a model.
Yeah, I know, but she could be.
She's a lot older than she actually is.
She
does.
She said she was 18.
She's not.
Oh, I know.
I can just see her just getting so leery.
Because she's a drama student, isn't she?
I know. After
she's not a
she'll
model.
Do something.
But...
She'll do something, but yeah. I don't think it's this.
Thank you all for waiting. I'm sorry none of you have made it through.
They're so bad. I didn't want to come off like I was just trying to... Because I know this is, if you give me a chance...
You're obviously good at a lot of things and you've got a really, really big personality, but I'm telling you now, you're not model material. And so I'm hoping that we can help you by not putting you through to get you on the path of something you're going to be really successful at.
To refocus on, because you have got so much going for you, but it's not modelling.
And as the morning continues...
Is that called the windmill?
You're about as interesting as a doorknob, you know? Raise the... You know, it's like, you've got to sell yourself, because we can't do it for you.
London is failing to deliver.
You're pretty, but you're not a model.
Unfortunately, all of you will be going home.
Coming up, the judges show how it's done. Yeah! Has Julian found the woman of his dreams?
There she is. That's our Wonder Woman.
Oh, yeah! Yeah!
It's one girl's last chance to become Britain and Ireland's next top model.
I believe in dreams coming true, and I want this to come true.
What one special item would you have to bring with you?
I think it would be my Bible. It would be my strength. I'll bring that with me, definitely.
I've got nothing against religion. I went to Sunday school, but praise the Lord, she needs a personality.
So is the pressure just too much?
They can't take it anymore. You know, I've been to so many agencies, and they're like, oh, we can't take her. And I think, what is wrong with me?
We'll be right back. auditions for Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model are in London, and so far the judges have had little success. Hoping to change that is 22-year-old Brenda from Uganda, and this could not mean more to her.
As a child, I used to wake up and just talk about it. I wish I could be a model. I believe in dreams coming true, and I want this to come true.
If we were to put you through to the house, what one special item would you have to bring with you?
I think it would be my Bible. It would be my strength. I'll bring that with me, definitely.
So bearing that in mind, so let's say some of the more sensual and raunchy and maybe more sexual shoots, how would you feel about those?
I've done bikini and stuff, and I've talked to my pastors and stuff. I thought, what did you think about doing bikini? And they said, it's what the mindset that you have behind it.
Absolutely.
You know? I think it would stop
well
me.
Done.
No, it wouldn't stop.
It's what God gave you.
Oh yeah, exactly.
Some people
so you
would
have
look
to show
at that.
It.
You know, there ain't nothing simple
yes,
about that.
Definitely.
I'd love to see how you walk.
Very relaxed.
Yeah, and really elegant.
Very gracious. Might have found ourselves a new Alec Weck then.
Wow, yeah. Thank you.
Next.
How would you feel if we shaved your hair off?
I'd do it.
You would do anything to win this competition.
Yeah, well, not anything to win this competition. That makes them sound like they're really sort of cheap and nasty.
Yeah, I mean, you've got to
do anything to win the competition.
The thing is, you've got to be in it to win it. And do you know what? The winner takes all.
Like number five, I thought
yeah,
she was
I
something sort
well.
Of tiff about
that's,
her.
I've spotted her a mile away. I think
know.
That's somebody's favourite.
I know.
I think
well, I don't know that she's a favourite, but I do think she's a contender.
I'm not sure how I got on, iffy. I was very nervous, but hopefully did a lot of smiling.
The Bible girl was good.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
She was really beautiful. What I thought was really interesting is that she'd already discussed it with her pastor, which is great because she'd done her research.
I think I gave my best, so let's see what happens.
They bring up the Bible and you just think, oh, God, they're so dull. They don't do anything. You know,
That's
they're afraid
not true.
To do anything.
Jules, you're being so judgmental.
I've got nothing against religion. I went to Sunday school, but praise the Lord, she needs a personality.
Welcome back. Today we can only put a select number of girls through. First girl is... The first girl who's through to the semi-finals is Jordan.
Wow, I'm so enthusiastic about this. I'm so glad we put you through.
And we have only one other girl through to the semi-finals today. The other girl we've chosen today, we've chosen for her looks and for her elegance. And that is Brenda.
Thank you so much. Oh.
So Brenda, I'm just a little bit worried because when we were watching you before us, you seemed like there's a really heavy weight on you. And I'm just wondering if there's something going on for you today. It's okay.
It's so good that someone can say yes to you. You know, it's amazing. I came here and thought, oh God, not another no, please. I can't take it anymore. You know, I've been to so many agencies and they're like, oh, we can't take her. And I think, what is wrong with me? Thank you.
Nothing's wrong with
you. Oh, don't. You're going to stop me crying now.
That was just pulling on all of my heartstrings.
Yeah,
me too. Those big tears.
Me too.
That was so real, more real than any of the girls that I've seen here before crying.
Niagara Falls.
There's always a bright future ahead. It's amazing. Oh my God, my neck is shaking.
And Brenda won't be the only one celebrating tonight.
Well done.
I think I'm going to have to be a stable girl for the rest of my life.
No, they said yes.
Okay.
Okay.
It's time for lunch, no?
I'm hungry.
Basically, as a model, this is all I have for lunch. Yeah, just put the veg on the plate for the camera and then just rip it off.
That's what I'm going to have for my lunch. Just one piece of melon on a diet.
After that big lunch, it's a quick catwalk workout for the judges. And the afternoon kickstarts with a sing-song.
About to go into a song.
Stop.
In the name of love, before you break my heart, think you don't know what we're
about. She's going to kiss you. Charley, she wants to kiss you.
As some try to bribe their way into the semi-finals with kisses and cuddles, others reveal more than necessary.
So would you class yourself as a typical Essex girl? Do you wear a vajazzle?
What is that?
They tattoo like diamonds on your...
Yeah. Oh, gosh, I wear those. Is that bad?
I don't think that's a vajazzle.
OK, guys, so, you know, I have to go. I've got to shoot tomorrow. I've got to get on a plane. But I totally trust you to be my eyes and ears. OK.
Yeah, go. Definitely.
Thanks.
Have a good shootout.
Good luck.
Looking hard. Woo!
Give us your best catwalk.
Yeah! It's Fizzy McFizzy on the runway.
Jessica is next to see the judges. And at 23 years old, it's the last year she can apply for the competition. And realistically, her last chance to fulfil her dream of a career in modelling.
It's something I've always wanted. It's always been in me. I mean, my mum used to say that she could feel me stomping around when she was pregnant with me. And I could do it because I think I've got a certain unique look. And I have a word, and my word is iconic, and that's what I want to be. And that's what I think I could be.
Well, I'm very excited with one because she's got that fabulous coat on. You can see it's full of enthusiasm, yes, just bursting to come out.
You've got to take that coat off, though, sorry.
I was going to do a little walk and then...
No!
Right into it.
No, that's like proper, like, horrible commercial catwalk show.
I am dying to see what is underneath that dress.
Whoa.
So just come into the middle so we can see you.
Wow.
There she is. That's a Wonder Woman.
Oh,
there she
is. Whoa.
I'm so nerve-wracking.
She's definitely got
through.
I don't want to be really confident and then come back down and I'm like, no.
She's got this incredible body, this confidence. Mm. She does look like a little bit like a man body because she's so athletic.
You are right.
But you know what? Yeah. It's like, I'd like to show her to Elle.
I know, I'm sure you'd like to do something.
All right.
Right.
Get him in.
We are looking for somebody, you know, different and unique. And that very lucky, special girl. It's Miss Dynamite, it's Jess.
Well done.
Last but not least.
You are completely different.
And you're, you know, in a way, extraordinary, and that's what we're looking for here. Okay.
So well done.
Oh, give us a hug, come on.
Come on, give him a hug.
You made our team.
Get going.
I didn't tell you, but I've been auditioning for Britain's Next Top Model and they picked me, so I've just got through. So, yeah.
I think it's really fantastic to find a girl who's strong, confident, and who's not just a box standard model. You know, she's something special, and this show is about championing new people, and I think she's great.
I'm quite happy. Oh, coming up, Rosie. Stay close to me.
Hold on, stay close to me. So as the auditions wave goodbye to London, the girls who are one step closer to becoming Britain and Ireland's next top model will be celebrating tonight. episode of Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model, we're in Cardiff.
This is Cardiff! Woo!
Elle surprises the streets of Birmingham.
Any pretty girls around?
In the audition room, there's tears.
I've wanted to do it for so long.
And joy for the girls.
Oh my God!
And the judges find it hard to agree.
We've teamed up with Diet Coke to give you and a friend the chance to win a day's VIP ticket to Britain and Ireland's Next Top Model Live from 28th to 30th of October at London's XL Centre. Be a VIP for the day with £1,000 spending money. To enter, simply answer this question. Which judge opened BNTM Live last year? A. Grace Woodward. B. Julian McDonald. C. Charley Speed. To enter and for full terms and conditions, go to sky.com/skyliving. Entrance must be over 18. Closing date midnight, 31st of July.
Behind the scenes videos, exclusive interviews, stunning pictures and all the latest model gossip. Just head to sky.com/BINTM. The competition heats up next Monday at 9. And this Thursday at 8, they're about to put the badass in Beacon Hill. The hottest new cast since Twilight hits the ground running in all new teamwork.